Welcome to this ASP.NET Core PDF Viewer Control tutorial. The ASP.NET Core PDF Viewer Control allows you to view, print, zoom, search, scroll, and select text and PDFs. You can use annotation tools for highlighting words, adding shapes, stamps, and drawing ink, and you can fill and design custom forms. This video will explain you how to integrate this standalone PDF viewer control into an ASP.NET Core application. You will also see how to load a PDF document from a URL to the PDF viewer. First, I open Visual Studio 2022 and select Create a New Project from the Project Dashboard. I choose an ASP.NET Core web app from the list of project templates and name the project PDF Viewer Sample. I will continue with the .NET 8 framework and click the Create button to start the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. Next, I will show you the step-by-step process for adding a Syncfusion ASP.NET Core PDF Viewer to it. First, I open the NuGet Package Manager. In the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion EJ2 ASP.NET Core package. And install it in my application. Once the package is installed, you can find it under the Packages section. Next, I open the View Import CSHTML file under the Views folder and import the Syncfusion EJ2 tag helper. Then I navigate to the Layout CSHTML file under the Shared folder. Within that file, I add a Syncfusion CSS style reference using the CDN link. Next, I add the script reference using the CDN link. Afterward, I register the script manager using the EJS scripts tag at the end of the body section. I must then register the Syncfusion license. To avoid a license validation message, I open the program file and register the Syncfusion license key using the register license method. To know where to generate the Syncfusion license key, refer to the link in the video description. To add a PDF viewer, navigate to the index.cshtml file and remove the existing code. Then I add the EJS PDF viewer tag. Next, I set the ID attribute and the height of the PDF viewer control. Look here, I am going to load this PDF document into the PDF viewer control. So, within this control code, I pass the document URL to the document path property. Now, save the changes and run the application. As you can see, the PDF viewer now loads and displays the PDF document from the provided URL. In this video, I have shown you how to create an ASP.NET Core web application and add the Syncfusion PDF viewer package. You also saw how to load a PDF document from a URL to the PDF viewer. To learn more about PDF viewer features, you can check the documentation link provided in the description below. You can download a working example from the GitHub link. In the description, I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our PDF viewer control through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching this video.